Good morning. Welcome here this Monday morning to your live daily devotional. I'm Michelle Morrow. As many of you know, you've been joining me for a long, long time since June 4th when I started this live broadcast. Maybe I'm amazed at the way he loves me. Well, I am amazed at the way he loves me and the way he loves you. And I'm not only here to expose the works of the devil, but I'm here to demonstrate God's great love and his great power for you. He is real. All the musicians and producers present, you're going to know where I'm going with this one. Right? Maybe I'm amazed at the way you love me all the time. Maybe I'm amazed at the way I love you. Brian Duncan. Maybe I'm amazed. I need you, Lord. You're the only one that can ever help us. I'm gonna not sing. Sorry. I'm digging that drummer. How sweet the song of amazing grace, God's unmerited favor. Saved a wretch like me. He's gonna save you. Put your trust in him. Yes. Yeah, Pam, you love your drummer. Lord, thank you for meeting us here, Holy Spirit. We invite you, we love you, we adore you, we worship you. We are amazed at your love, the way you love us unconditionally. We don't even deserve it. Isn't it hard to believe sometimes? I'm amazed at the way he loves me. What a great way to start your day. In the greatest love relationship of all. Jesus. Brian Duncan. I've been listening to Brian for years. My friend, music producer Carmine Rubino, reminded me of him over the weekend, and I just could not resist. I went and subscribed to the YouTube page and began following Brian, and up came this rendition of Maybe I'm Amazed from about 8 years ago, and it really touched my heart, and I thought I would share it with you this morning, because it really went along with what the Holy Spirit was speaking to me and asking me to talk with you about this morning. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's great to see you this morning. If you're not friends with me on Facebook, I can't see you coming in the room, but I want you to know that you are welcome here always. Always, always, always. And it's good to have you here this morning. God, COVID-19 has exposed it all, hasn't it? I'm here doing this assignment from the Lord to expose the work of the devil in all of it, yes, but to also demonstrate the love of the Father. And I hope, and my hope is that you will begin to put your trust in Him, and you will do for Jesus what you have never done for anyone else before. And that's what I feel like I'm doing these days. God, this is a house of glory. Lord, thank you that this is a house of glory. Father, we invite your Holy Spirit. We love you. We adore you. We worship and exalt you. There is no name above your name. Your name is above every other name. Tear down any and all idols, anything that we're putting before you. Oh God, tear it down this morning. Pull down those strongholds. Loose your spirit of humility, of prosperity, of health. In Jesus' mighty name, place around us the blood of the Lamb, shield of protection. Guard our heart, soul, body, mind, and our spirit. Let nothing, Lord, but your love penetrate that blood of the Lamb, shield of protection, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Place on us the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt buckle of truth. Shod our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace of Jesus Christ. Place in our hand the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, sharper than any two double-edged sword. Place in our other hand the shield of faith to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, yours is the power. We feel it here now. And yours is the glory. Glory, glory, glory. Come in. You are welcome. We usher in your presence this morning, and there's nothing that we want more than to be in relationship with you. There's nothing that we want more than to empty ourselves this morning and enter into this great love relationship, the greatest love of all, right? Oh, Lord. reminds me of something. And I'm going to see if I can find it. Has everything to do with the greatest love of all. See if I can find it. Forgive the light on my face. See if I can find it. That's pretty important, but I don't know if I can find it on my computer because I saved it on my phone, and my phone is being used now for this broadcast, so just bear with me for a minute, and it might come up here. Not coming up. Oh, I want to share this with you. Darn it. Okay, that's warfare. I'll leave that alone for a minute. Good morning and welcome to the House of Glory, where we praise God, Jesus, and David Gabb is in the house. Welcome. It's good to have you here this morning, David. John and Pam Hart are here, and Pam says she loves her drummer. Amen. Steve Hilstein, co-producer, is here. Welcome. You are such a joy in my life. And Greg Mallory, welcome. Olivia from the UK, welcome. You're a sweetheart, and I'm so thankful that you are here this morning. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Ah, Jesus, thank you, Father, for your presence this morning. All of your presence, the good gifts that you give your children. Have you tried the church? Have you tried going to church? Well, this is a little bit different. Here, you're going to try Jesus, right? I'm just a conduit. I'm just a vessel being used by God, and He is using me, but He's also changing my heart. He's teaching me a lot through this. I'm learning. You know how a teacher learns through teaching. And I don't really feel like a teacher. I'm a praying girl, sinning girl who prays. And I'm good at praying. I've been doing it for years. So, yeah. So, yeah, that's what I'm an expert at praying. But I just feel like, gosh, the Lord is using me. And at the same time, He is teaching me so much and growing me. And He's given me a new assignment. And, He's given me a new assignment, and I'm going to tell you about that a little bit later. Perhaps tomorrow morning, I'll tell you a lot more about that. I didn't prepare for it this morning, and it's difficult for me to articulate it without referring to my notes. So here we're going to go straight into the Word now that we have been amazed by the Lord and His presence. We're going to go right into Jeremiah this morning. Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 3. Praise the Lord. Let's go to the Old Testament and turn with me, if you will, to Jeremiah. Wow, I had it marked inadvertently a few pages really close to 31. Oh, that's awesome. Let me put this here. Jeremiah 31, 3. I'm sorry about all the noise. You know, the paper makes a lot of noise in the broadcast. So sorry about that. I forget sometimes. The Lord has appeared of old to me, saying, "Yes, I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness, I have drawn you." That's what He's doing, Holy Spirit. God the Father, Jesus Christ, the Trinity has drawn you by the power of the Holy Spirit in to him. It says here in the word in Jeremiah, again, I will build you and you shall be rebuilt, O virgin of Israel. You shall again be adorned with your tambourines and shall go forth in the dances of those who rejoice. You shall yet plant vines on the mountains of Samaria. The planters shall plant and eat them as ordinary food. There shall be a day when the watchman will cry on Mount Ephraim, arise and let us go up to Zion for the Lord our God. Good morning, Jan, the Polka King, friend of mine from Florida, West Palm Beach, Florida. Good morning, love. Welcome. It's good to have you here this morning. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. For there shall be a day when the watchmen will cry on Mount Ephraim. The watchmen are the intercessors praying and interceding for the nations, for the president of the United States of America, and all of our leadership within our states and our cities. It's time. The remnant is rising. I shared a message this morning from Jeremiah Johnson, who is setting the hearts of man on fire with the love of Jesus Christ. This is a house of glory, and I am bringing a message of hope for your future, because I'm bringing the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and there is a remnant rising. There are soldiers being raised up in the army that God is amassing, and he is lighting on our hearts on fire. He is making the world, the entire globe, aware of his presence through the soldiers. And I am one of those soldiers. I'm just a willing, amazing God. You are an amazing God. I'm just a willing, simple girl who loves the Lord with all her heart, soul, body, mind, and her strength. And I'm coming to you to share the message of his great love. And that's what the message is all about. Maybe I'm amazed at the way he could love me out of my sinful lifestyle. Maybe I'm amazed at the way God Jesus came in and captivated my heart and said, oh no, you don't. Oh no, you don't. Turn away from Satan and stop aligning yourself with him. Turn full face towards me, said the Lord God Almighty. And I did that, and my goodness, the blessings have begun to flow as I've recommitted my life and began walking very closely with him. John 3:16, for wow, I'm amazed at his great love. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm amazed. Maybe I'm amazed at the way you love me. Maybe I'm amazed at the way you demonstrate your great love through creation. Maybe I'm amazed at the way you demonstrate your great love through life. He knows you. He formed you in the womb. He knows every hair on your head. God gave his only begotten Son for you, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. The very essence of God is light and life, and he is love. God is love. Thank you, Jesus. John 15:9, fourth book in the New Testament. John 15. Everybody knows this is my favorite book. Ah, yes. Verse 9. As the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. And these are the red letters. Jesus said them himself. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may remain in you and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. You are my friends if you do whatever I command you. I took this assignment because I am friends with God. I've taken my next assignment also because I am his friend. No longer do I call you servants, for a servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends. For all things that I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. These things I command you, that you love one another. I pray according to God's will, and he blesses me with every single thing that I ask for. I believe it before I receive it. He's calling you out today. He wants to know if you will act before he will give you the evidence of what he will do for you. Think about that. Think about it for a minute. Will you act before he gives you evidence of what he will do for you? In other words, walk out your faith. Walk out your faith with me. Come along with me on this great adventure. Be a demonstrator of God's great love. Yes. Good morning. Dawn is in the house, my good friend Dawn. Love you very much. And Carmine Rubino. I played Maybe I'm Amazed at the beginning. We worshiped to Brian Duncan. It was amazing. God's amazing. Demi Lee, good morning. It's great to have you here this morning. Yay, Lord. 2 Thessalonians. Keep going. In your New Testament. 2 Thessalonians. I believe it's just after Corinthians. Let's see if I'm right. No. Yeah, after Colossians. Okay. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. It's very short. Now to the right verse. 2:16. My birth date's 16. 2:16. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself, in our God and Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting consolation and good hope by grace, which is unmerited favor. Surely we don't deserve his great love. Comfort your hearts and establish you in every good word and work. Praise the Lord. As we commit our works to the Lord, our plans will be established. Proverbs 3:16. And Proverbs 3:6. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. God, you are good. You are a good, good Father. 1 John 4:8. 1 John 4:8. Go a little further with me. This is one of my favorite verses that I speak of quite often. Let's go back up into 1 John 4:7. Beloved, he's talking to you right now. Let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. And 1 John 4:16. And we have known and believed the love that God has for us. God is love, and he who abides in love abides in God, and God in him. Maybe I'm amazed at how much love he has for me. After all, I've sinned. I've fallen so short of his grace and mercy. I found out I couldn't do life on my own. It wasn't working out great for me on my own at all. So I returned to him, the greatest love of all. You know, that song by Whitney Houston used to minister to me. I loved her. I loved her voice. I used to emulate her. I used to sing in the living room. I used to turn it up. And I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. I want to emulate Christ Jesus. I want to demonstrate his great love. Have you tried church? This is different. This is different. You're trying on Jesus, the greatest love of all. The greatest love of all. And through this love relationship with him, as you return back to him, you're going to want nothing more than to not forsake the assembling of the body of Jesus Christ. You're going to long to go back to church, and the church is open. The church is open for business. That's right. The church is open, and we're going to continue to assemble together and demonstrate God's great love. There is so much love that God Jesus is pouring out over the nations. It starts in your heart, and it starts here in my heart. And the great works that he's begun, he will finish. He will complete it in you. Amen. 1 John 4:16. We just read. In Ephesians chapter 2. Let's check it out. I have to back up a little. Ephesians chapter 2. Dear God, what are you showing us this morning? Verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy, oh, thank you, Lord, that you are rich in mercy for your children, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses, made us alive together with Christ by grace, or better known as unmerited favor, you have been saved and raised up together and made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace, unmerited favor, in his kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. He wants us and desires for us to walk in his great love, demonstrating his great love. And by doing that, yeah, exposing Satan and his evil tactics. Eric Britton, good morning and welcome. It's great to have you here this morning. Eric says, Satan wants to keep you masked. That's right. Jesus wants you to be free. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Amen. There is liberty. Jesus came to save us. He came to set the captives free. He's doing this today by exposing the vile works of the enemy. Satan, your days are numbered and you know it. And all those little imps you have working for you, they're going down. There's a shadow shining on the map, the world map I have above, and it's a fist bump. I see a shadow of it. Do you see that right there? To me, it looks like a fist bump, but I don't see that well. So, yes, I do see well. I see in the spirit. I have the gift of discerning of spirits. And praise the Lord. I love it. I walk in it. Ephesians 2:4. It's fantastic. The next verse is Zephaniah chapter 3. Zephaniah, back there, back it up into the Old Testament. Might be the last one. Let me see. No, it's not. That's not, but it's close. Okay, one of the last books in the Old Testament. Zephaniah chapter 3, 17. What does your word say, O God, about your great love for us? The Lord your God in your midst, the mighty one, will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing. I will gather those who sorrow over the appointed assembly, who are among you, to whom its reproach is a burden. Behold, at that time, I will deal with all who afflict you. I will save the lame and gather those who were driven out. I will appoint them for praise and fame in every land where they were put to shame. At that time, I will bring you back. Even at that time, I gather you, for I will give you fame and praise among all the peoples of the earth when I return your captives before your eyes, says the Lord. He brought me back, and he is bringing you back, right? He is turning you back to his great love. He is using me. He is using many, many, many of us to demonstrate his love and bring you back to him, the greatest love of all. Isaiah 49. Isaiah. I love you, Isaiah. Isaiah. I don't like to mark it. I like to page through and remind myself of the addresses of the verses 15 through 16. Can a woman forget her nursing child and not have compassion on the son of her womb? Surely they may forget, yet I will not forget you. See, I have inscribed you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are continually before me. Your sons shall make haste. Your destroyers and those who laid you waste shall go away from you. Psalm 91. Lift up your eyes and look around and see all these gather together and come to you. As I live, says the Lord, Jesus Christ is alive today. He is, he was, and is to come. You shall surely clothe yourselves with them all as an ornament and bind them on you as a bride does. For your waste and desolate places in the land of your destruction will even now be too small for the inhabitants. And those who swallowed you up will be far away. The children you will have after you have lost the others will say again in your ears, the place is too small for me. Give me a place where I may dwell. Then you will say in your heart, who has begotten these for me? Since I have lost my children, I am desolate, a captive and wandering to and fro. And who has brought these up? There I was, left alone. But these, where were they? Thus says the Lord. Behold, I will lift my hand in an oath to the nations and set up my standard for the peoples. They shall bring your sons in their arms, and your daughters shall be carried on their shoulders. Kings shall be your foster fathers, and their queens your nursing mothers. They shall bow down to you with their faces to the earth and lick up the dust of your feet. Then you will know that I am the Lord, for they shall not be ashamed who wait for me. He loves the righteous. He has called you friend because you have known him, because you know him now. Ooh. Romans 8. Back to the New Testament. Romans chapter 8. Lord, thank you for your fiery presence. Jesus, 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 the name above all names. The name above all names. Eric Britton says, Gavin, nuance, nuisance. Gruesome says we shouldn't sing. Yeah. Lord, we pray for Gavin Newsom in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, bring a charge of angels to surround him, to whisper in his ear, to consistently and constantly be reminding him that you are the greatest love of all. We call salvation. Salvation come to Gavin Newsom. Radically save him and change him and change the direction. Thank you, Lord, that you are changing the direction of California. Thank you that you are raising up a remnant in our state. And we know that California leads the nation, right? We thank you that you are, with the blood of Jesus Christ, turning this nation red. Amen. Raise your voices high with me and with Eric as we, as two or more are gathered there in my name, I will be there. He is going to answer our prayers. Thank you for saving Gavin in Jesus' mighty name. Salvation come to everyone that does not know you. We call in salvation this morning. Jesus' mighty name, give us a love for our enemies, Lord, that we would pray for them, that we would hear you and pray for them. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Lord, you are good. Romans 8, come on, come on. Praise him with me. 38 and 39, this is really, really good. Lord, I pray, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Let me say it again. I am persuaded that neither death, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Thank you, Father. Let nothing separate us from your love. Let nothing come between the greatest love of all. Nothing can separate you. No weapon formed against you can prosper in the name of Jesus Christ. He formed you in the womb. He knew you. He knew you when he designed you, when he spoke life into existence, when he created the earth and the heavens. He knew you then. All you have to do is acknowledge that you are a sinner, that you can't do life on your own. All you need to do is believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that the only way to the Father God is through Jesus Christ. All you have to do is call him out right now. Jesus, Jesus, come, bring salvation into my heart, bring it into the hearts of the listeners. Whoever's listening to this live message, you are here. It is not a coincidence. It was God, Jesus. It was his design, his plan, and his purpose to enter into a loving relationship with you, the greatest love of all. It was his design and his plan and his destiny, his purpose for your life, to draw you into him. If you're backslidden, it's to draw you back to him. You've fallen away from him, and he wants nothing more than to have you back. He forgives it all. He forgives it all. Ask him right now, Father, empty me of all of it, all of the past, the tormenting spirits. I bind you, spirits, tormenting spirits, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, O God, that you would loose from heaven a humble spirit over all your people listening this morning. I pray, O God, that you would loose the spirit of prosperity, the spirit of health, in Jesus' mighty name. Acknowledge that you can't do life on your own. Believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and he's the only way to the Father. Call him out now. Maybe I'm amazed at the way he called me back to him. Maybe I'm so amazed that there's nothing that I want to do more in this life, in my life today, than share that great love that he has for me, but that he has for you. I am so amazed at, after what I have done, that he can offer me his unmerited favor, his grace. It is more than enough. His grace is sufficient for me, and it's sufficient for you. So Heavenly Father, as we leave here today, Father, I thank you that you will stay with us. You will stay with us by the power of your Holy Spirit. You will continue to show us signs and wonders today. You will continue to demonstrate your great love inside of us. Use us as your hands and feet today, Lord, to demonstrate that great love that you have for us. God loves you. I love you. I'll see you tomorrow morning for another live daily devotional. God bless you and your family.